Hi everyone, Zach Reinhardt here for CityBoost.com, and in this video let's turn this low poly base human into a low poly version of ourselves. This video here is part of the new character creation and rigging chapter I added to the Blender Cubic Worlds course, where you will learn how to create and rig low poly characters and animals. This update comes free for everyone that owns the course already, and if you haven't jumped in, check the link down below in the video description. So, to better follow this video here, let me first give you a bit of context. In the cubic world style, we build everything out of cubes, which we can deform in any way, but we won't subdivide them in any form. This allows us to be more creative and quickly create assets in a distinct low poly style, so we can focus on creating nice art and animations rather than spending hours on creating assets. We are also using a simple shader node group, which I created, to quickly color everything in our scene by adjusting a few sliders. To follow this video here, you can download a base male or female character, including the shader node group, from the link in the video description. However, the asset library, which you can see in this video here, is not included in the free file, just the basic cubes we are using. To use the asset browser in Blender, you have to download the latest build of Blender 3.0 Alpha, link in the video description. And of course, in the Cubic Worlds course itself, you will learn about all the Cubic Worlds workflows in detail. When you created your own low poly self, make sure to share it with us on social media. I would love to see your results. And now, enjoy the video. So, and I just look at myself right now, what I'm wearing, and I will recreate myself using this character here as basis. So first of all, let's adjust the colors a bit. So I'm wearing a dark blue shirt. So let's change the male sweater here to some dark bluish, something like this. However, we have short sleeves. That means let's switch to edit mode. Let's select these four cubes here, go to the skin color and hit assign. Then let's enable X symmetry here, Alt A, deselect everything, then select this here. And with Alt S, I can shrink fatten this. So I shrink this down a bit so I don't have this big lower arms. Well, my belly is a bit wider, I think. Let's push this a bit to the front. Then let's grab this one here, move this to the front. Let's grab this one, move this, same over here. Then I wear a black belt. So let's go to the belt and backspace the color to gray and make it pretty dark. And since it's summertime currently, I'm wearing short pants with a light blue color. So let's go to pants, make this brighter and go with a light blue. And here, since the pants are not going to the knees, they are somewhere above here. What we can do, let's simply select these two, Shift D, Alt S to shrink fatten this, make it a bit bigger. Then with a face selection, let's select these two and press double G to slide this up here, something like this. Then I can select these here and apply the skin material. And again, with Alt S, let's shrink fatten this down a bit and scale it a bit longer. And for the shoes, I also wear like dark blue shoes. And these shoes have some pretty strong wide soles. So let's simply grab these cubes here, Shift D, disable X symmetry, scale them down, make them a bit wider, move this down here, Shift D, move this to the front, scale this a bit. Something like this. Then let's create a new material, search for the male shoes, duplicate this and just call it male shoes 2, and then give it a whitish color and hit assign. Maybe let's move this down a bit. Something like this. Maybe the sweater is a bit too dark. So the hair color is pretty much correct. However, there are two things missing. I have a beard and I wear glasses. So let's start with the beard. Let's go to edit mode. Let's with L select one of these cubes up here, Shift D, move it down. And although my beard is not that intense, let's say, we can only work with cubes here. So I think it will look a bit more intense than in the real world. Then there's a connection line between the beard and the hair. Maybe let's put something like this here. And very important, the height should not be the same here, so we don't have this weird clipping. So let's scale this one here a bit further, something like this. Then let's duplicate this, place it somewhere here to add a bit variation to the beard. Add a little patch over here and Shift D, let's move this to the side here. move this up a bit, and let's move this also to the other side. Sometimes when you do the stuff on the other side, it doesn't have to be like perfectly straight and mirrored in any way, because humans are a bit more organic and non-symmetrical, so that's totally fine. And now all there's left to do is adding the classes. For that, let's add the empty. Let's call this mirror, and let's go with a cube bottom here, Alt G, scale it down, add the mirror modifier and the mirror empty object, and then we can easily create the classes. And the classes are dark blue from the outside, so let's use a base material here, duplicate this, call this male glasses blue. Let's use a default diffuse cubic worlds shader, make this darkish bluish, something like this. And then let's rotate this, place it somewhere here, closer to the body, of course. Then from the top, Shift D, let's duplicate this. Let's go with a global transform orientation. I think it's currently a bit easier to work with. Scale this down so we have this tiny part here. Then Shift D, move it over here. Always change the size of these cubes a bit. So I have this metal frame, which is only on the top. And then let's add one cube here. And here I just remove the mirror modifier because it's in the center. Right click, set origin, origin to geometry. Then let's press N and set the X value to 0. So it's exactly in the center. Move it up here, scale it down. And then let's grab this one here, Shift D. Make it a bit flatter, a bit smaller, and scale this up. This should be the glass. So let's duplicate this, call this male glasses glass. Change this to be a transparent shader. Here let's use a very light bluish color. Specular, let's set this to white. Let's give it 0.1 transparency. And of course, under settings, change the blend mode to alpha blend, shadow mode to alpha hashed. Then we can look through here and maybe let's disable the gradient button and reduce the gradient edge here. Then I have the glasses here. And actually, let's duplicate this one here. We have this thing going on here and a similar thing on the other side. And the glass is slightly shaped like this. So with the edge selection, let's slide this over a bit. So now we still have some separate objects here, but in this case, I would just select everything from the glasses, Control A, and then Visual Geometry to Mesh to apply all the modifiers, and then just join this to the body here. Then here in Edit Mode, let's select everything one more time, press U and click on Reset to reset the UV map, and make sure that the scale is applied. And to make everything correct here, let's rename all the materials to Zag. So what we can do, let's press Control F2 to open up the Batch Rename menu. Here we want to rename the materials. Of course, the character needs to be selected. Find male and replace it by Zag. Hit OK. Now you can see all the males were replaced by Zag. Up here, let's call this character Zag. And then we can remove the mirroring empty. And voila, here is the current version of Zag. Yeah, now we have a low poly version of ourselves. Make sure to share a render or screenshot of your low poly self on social media with us and make sure to tag us. And now if you want to learn how to bring this character to life by properly rigging it with facial expressions, there's a detailed chapter about that in my Blender Cubic Worlds course, link in the video description. Hope you had fun with this video and you learned a thing or two, and I will see you in the next one. Goodbye.